When it comes to creative post-processing, one of the most commonly used look is what is known as a vintage look or a faded film look. Though the name suggests vintage or faded film, not most of these presets or the look are actually dating back to the film days. One such look that we are going to learn today, which is known as Bleach Bypass look, it actually has its root in the color film days. The origin of this particular look dates back to early 1900s, and in fact, there was a movie which was also completely processed in this particular look, which was called Hey Brother, and it was released in 1960s, and it was a Japanese movie. In earlier days, the bleach bypass look was achieved by doing what is known as a partial or a complete skipping of the bleaching process. This resulted in something more of like a high key, low saturation and a high contrast image. This effect is easily reproducible in digital days using Photoshop or alternatives that we have in the market. So let's jump in and learn how to get the bleach bypass look using Photoshop. And for those of you guys who are wondering, what if I don't have a Photoshop and how do I do this? Stay tuned till the end of this video and I'm going to teach you how to get this exact look using the free alternative to Photoshop, which is GIMP. To give you a heads up on how to achieve this effect, I would say it's very easy, very fast with minimal number of steps. So as a first step, we open the image in Photoshop, which we would have ideally shot in RAW and processed it using any of your favorite RAW processing tool. Now, next, duplicate the layer using Command J option or dragging and dropping the image layer to the new layer icon. Now go to Image, Adjustments, Desaturate. Bang! We wanted to give a vintage look and the image ended up being more interesting black and white image. Now to the most interesting and a key step, a secret sauce which most folks generally avoid looking into, the blend modes. Click on the drop down and select Overlay. That's your bleach bypass look. You can stop at this moment or maybe tweak the opacity of the second layer to suit your taste. Let's look into one more image and figure out few other variations. As I mentioned in the previous image, the first important step is to create a desaturated or a black and white version of the image. And desaturate is not the only option that is available in Photoshop. One can get creative in the way they process to get the black and white images and take it forward for a more refined and a creative final result. Couple of other ways to do it are either by using the HSL layer or best if you can use the black and white adjustment layer. The black and white adjustment layer gives infinite number of options to get the best possible final results. Once done, the next and final step is pretty straightforward. Go to the blend mode and choose overlay. For a more subtle effect, one can even choose soft light. But overlay along with opacity slider adjustment can give you a much closer result. Now for the most important question, what if you don't have a copy of Photoshop? Can't you process your image to get this result? The good news is that you can do it using the most popular free tool, GIMP. The steps remain exactly the same. Open the image in GIMP, duplicate the image layer, use the colors desaturate option to convert it to black and white. Here again, you have multiple sub-options to fine-tune the black and white conversion. But once done, go to the mode and choose overlay. And if need be, use the opacity option to play around to get the final result that you want. So hope you learned something new today, a new way of processing your images using Photoshop or GIMP. And a word of caution from my end, just because it's a new look that you learned today, it doesn't mean that you can try it out on every single type of images. Based on my experience, this is more suited for a travel or architecture or street photography kind of images. And if you're someone who does more of wedding photography or kids photography, I would say you probably try to avoid this particular look because you might end up losing your job for the type of images that you'll give to your client. So this is me, Shiv, signing off for this video, and I'll see you back in the next one.